everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another edition of AGP Unboxed. Today we're going to have a look inside the Captain of the Empire blister pack here from the new Empire line of miniatures that GW has just put out. First of all, the packaging, very interesting. Not really sure why they didn't go with the box style packaging. I guess because it's just one little sprue in here, obviously. And in some ways, it's kind of nice to be able to see what you're getting ahead of time, although I do wish that they would have flipped the sprue around so that you'd actually be able to see more of the miniature instead of mostly just the detail of the base. But that's really neither here nor there. I am very curious how to get this thing open. I think that the best way to do it is to pull on this little tab that they have included right here, and I'm betting that that will open the box without any sort of weaponry at all, i.e. hobby knife, but I could be wrong, and it turns out that I am. So what we're going to need is, I guess we can do it like this, strong pair of fingers. I was going to say we're going to need a hobby knife, but this will work just fine. Be careful whenever you're opening any of these heat-sealed packages. I have nearly lost a couple of fingers in previous experiences, not with any Warhammer stuff, but opening up these packages in the past has been somewhat risky at times. Alright, so as you saw previously, you get one sprue. That's it. Your instructions come on the back of the card, or the little piece of paper that shows the completed version of the miniature. Let's have a look at the sprue. Alright, let's zoom in here. Okay, first of all, we have the base. Alright, now this is basically, from what I can tell, probably going to be my only complaint about the entire miniature. I am not a fan of sculpted bases, and the reason is it makes every one of the miniatures look exactly alike. Alright, and so I would much have preferred this not be a sculpted base at all. It just be a nice, you know, flat black base like they include in most kits. But that being said, I know that GW is really trying to lean more towards the gaming side, and specifically the newer gamers, the newer modelers, and they're not going to want to take time to actually create a base from scratch. Okay, so I understand the reasoning behind it, but it still kind of annoys me, okay? But what we have on here is what appears to be a portion of a wagon wheel with some spokes coming out of it, possibly some rocky terrain, not really exactly sure what that's supposed to be. But the base itself is very well sculpted. I'm just not a huge fan of sculpted bases. All right, so we've got that. We have the main body of our captain. Very, very well done, very Empire-ish in its design. You've got really, really nice detail. You can see all of the braiding on all the ropes and things like that. You can see the individual links in the chains that are going around the model's neck holding this pendant, which if you look very, very closely, and I don't believe we can get a, let's see here. There we go. That's about as close as I can get without the camera unfocusing. You might be able to see inside there that there is a twin-tailed comet of Sigmar. Very, very well done there as far as the detail of the miniature goes. All right, so we've got that. We've got a couple of different heads for the miniature. We have this one, which is a more pompous, grandiose style head. The one that's featured actually on the cover art right here. Okay, so you have that head right there. And then you have this more subdued, sort of older looking captain's head right here. Not nearly as flashy as this one. This one has sort of the appearance of sort of a royalty kind of a guy, whereas this one over here sort of has the appearance of, yes, he could be a commander, but he's probably a volunteer troop type guy. Alright, so this guy looks like he's always in the army. This guy looks like, you know, he's just some guy that gets called up from time to time to take command. Alright, by the way, that reminds me, as far as being the captain, you know, Captain of the Empire, that is a huge freaking responsibility. That would be like saying that you're, you know, the corporal of the entire United States Army. That's asking a lot, all right? So that's a heck of a title. Just something struck me as kind of odd. All right, you've got the arm here that's holding this really, really well done crisp blade, and this very nicely done sword pommel and everything like that. Very, very cool stuff. You've got the like a skull pattern in the actual pommel itself. The hilt here, or the cross piece, has got some very decorative patterns. You've got a skull right there that you probably can't see. Some leather wrappings leading up to the crisp blade. Very, very well done plate mail here on the shoulder. And again, this is kind of what the end product looks like. So you can see the leather strappings right there. Really well done blade and things like that. The pommel does kind of get covered up here apparently by the hand, but that's all right. No big deal there. All right, let's see here. What is this? Okay, this is apparently, I think this is something that actually goes across there. This is kind of an extra piece. I'm not even sure if you have to put this on there. Let me take a look at the, no. All right, you don't. Okay, I was looking to see if there was like a slot on the side of the model's body into which this could go. This is basically an extra scabbard and an extra sword with some tassels hanging off of it. Nothing major. Odds are pretty good. I probably would not put it on the miniature. It's just kind of an extra piece of flair if you want it there. And then you also have the cape of the miniature back here. Very, very simplistically done. Not a whole lot of flair and flash to the cape itself. All right. Really nice looking miniature, though. Give me a couple of minutes. I'll put the thing together, and then I'll come back and I'll give you my final opinion of the entire kit. And there is our completed Captain of the Empire miniature. Very, very nice looking model. Highly recommend picking one of these up. I'll kind of go over some of the details of the model here in just a few moments. Really just a spectacular miniature as far as the level of detail and the quality goes. Putting it together, not a whole lot of problems. Mold lines were fairly minimal. The only difficult spot I had was back here behind the character's right knee. That was the only part that I had difficulty getting a knife into to clean up those mold lines. Trouble spots that you might run into on this miniature if you happen to pick one of these up. I had difficulty with the peg that was on the left foot over here that goes into the base. The peg itself is actually too large to fit into the hole, so I had to cut the peg down to about a third of its original size, and it slipped right on in. The only other trouble spot that I had was deciding where to place the cloak of the miniature. Generally speaking, cloaks are placed on the shoulders, but this one, not so. I then tried to place it on just the hips. That didn't work either. And so finally I went with a diagonal, and once I did that, I realized that the cloak is actually connecting this tassel that you see right here. You can see the tassel back there, and it runs all the way up through the chest, or across the chest, and connects over here with this part of the cloak as well. So it's actually a cross-body cloak, which I find, it's interesting, kind of a pain in the butt to figure out that's what they were attempting to do when they sculpted the miniature, but now that you know, if you happen to pick this model up, you're not going to have that problem. Overall, really, really nice miniature. Really my only two complaints. Number one, the sculpted base. There's nothing wrong with this base at all. It's really, really well detailed. I like the base. I'm just not a fan of sculpted bases. It sort of destroys the creativity process in a way. But again, you know, I understand fully GW is marketing towards more the younger gamer who may or may not have the experience in creating their own base. But that is neither here nor there. Again, the base itself, very, very nicely done. I would just prefer to have had a plain base, though. But anyway, that would have required that the right foot be straight, or that on that plane base I, you know, put a rock under his foot or something like that. Anyway, the only other complaint that I have is the cloak itself. I feel like the cloak is a little bit too flat for this miniature. The rest of the model, very flashy, very flary, a lot of pomp. Just take a look over here at the sleeve, for instance. Really puffy, very, very much imperialistic. You've got these wonderful tassels and gold chains and details in the chest and the armor area. You've got a lot of nice folds here in the legs, things like that. Just really, really well done. You've got these really awesome lengthy feathers here coming off of the hat. really, really nice crisp blade that you don't see very often done in miniature form. And then you have the cloak, which just seems like it's been thrown on kind of as an afterthought. I think that a couple of extra folds in the cloak would have really made it fit more fully with the miniature. As it is right now, it does fit, but it just doesn't have the same... It doesn't have the same flair that the rest of the miniature does. It just kind of sits there. It doesn't really look like it fits. As I said, I really think a couple of extra folds, not even like big ones like these, I'm talking about little folds like this one right here, if they had added in a few of those over here perhaps, I really think it would have made the cloak much, much more fully fit with the rest of the miniature. But again, overall, very nice kit. Highly recommend picking it up. Nothing wrong with the miniature at all as far as something that I would just say, oh, this is a horrible model. It's a really good kit, really nice looking miniature, and I'm definitely looking forward to picking this one up. Overall, taking into account the price of the miniature, the level of detail sculpted onto the model, the ease of putting it together, and the overall coolness of the miniature, I'm going to give this guy, let's say, a 7.5 out of 10. I think that's a nice, fair score. I think a couple of aesthetic changes would have been really, really nice. But overall, really, really good-looking miniature. Definitely recommend picking one up. And, yeah, that's about it, guys. It's just a really, really nice-looking model. And I definitely want to get this guy painted as soon as I can clear some of the other stuff off my painting table. Hope you've enjoyed this episode of AGP Unboxed. Hope this has inspired you to maybe go out and pick up your own Captain of the Empire miniature, or maybe another miniature that you've been thinking about picking up for a while. Maybe put some paint on something as well. Anyway, that's it, guys. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video. Be sure to check out our website, www.agpminis.com, where you'll find all of our latest DVD releases, be able to watch all of our free content before we post it here on YouTube, as well as view exclusive content not available anywhere else.